This is My Village Experience. I'm your host, Mesa Sar. Welcome.
Bourg Music Production.
Baby, take my way. You feed me, tell me love how you put it on. Get the only key, know how to turn it on. Hey, the way you need below my ear, the only words I want to hear.
Hello, villagers. This is another session of My Village, the podcast. Welcome. And today we have
Gamu.
You have Gamu. Gamu, how are you today?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm perfect. Well, it's Sunday, but it's still unexpected things happening. Yeah. But still, we're here. Mm-hmm. So, right from the top, if I ask you three things, if you would have like three things, either.
First thing would be my phone.
Okay, like most people right now, I think.
Second thing would be food.
Of course.
And
Hopefully you wouldn't keep rice in your pocket or something like that, but you should be good.
I know. Third thing, well, my family, I'd say.
Yeah, of course.
Well, why did I say third thing? Yeah, it would be actually the first thing.
The first thing, of course. Actually, it was not
in order.
In order.
Yeah, so three things.
Just three things. And from the top, it's not that easy, I know. So what is your background? Where are you from?
I'm from Senegal. I was born in Washington, actually, and I grew up in Senegal, and I came here for my studies.
And how long have you been in Washington, where you were born?
Well, I did not last long there. Okay. I was just born there, just born, but then basically. I went back there for summers sometimes, vacations, but yeah, that's it.
And in Senegal, how long have you, like,
my whole life. Pretty much my whole life.
So you have all your family there, or are they scattered?
Like, most of my family is in Senegal. I have family in Washington, New York, and
Like a lot
China.
Of Senegalese.
Yeah, my brother is in China.
Yeah, everywhere.
Yeah, kind of everywhere. Yes.
Exactly. It's like my family too. I have cousins like here in US and everywhere. So, and what did you want to be?
Well, I wouldn't say I want to be one thing in specific.
Okay.
There are a lot of things in mind. I don't want a career in something specific. Yeah. I want to be open to everything, every opportunity.
Okay.
So right now what I'm doing is music, partially, part-time. The first thing would be my studies, because I study in communication public relations.
Oh, perfect.
That's very interesting.
Yeah, and broad. It's a broad.
I actually really like my field, and my goal is actually to open a public relations office for me.
Yeah,
but first of all, work in organizations.
Yeah, of course. Yes. Like the nonprofits and
yes, even if it's volunteering, I want to start some. I want to have gain experience and then open my own.
Of course, course. And what led you to it? What led you to? Let's start with the studies. What led you to public relationship and?
Well, communication was something that was always there. In my courses during my childhood, it was something that I always had to deal with, even in class. Everything that was related to communication, writing, speaking, and even just the singing, everything is communication, so it was all about communication. Now, public relations, it was something I wanted to discover because I found the field interesting, like creating an image, changing
like the graphic design,
the perception
type.
Of something. Yes, that's something
and
that
the
really
interpretation that people can have
exactly of an organization, of a person. So that was very interesting for me,
and helping to
bring
a helping hand. So do you have like someone maybe in your family that is in public relations or communications?
Yes, I actually have an uncle in Washington, D.C.
Oh, wow.
So that uncle is in communication, kind of public relations.
Okay.
Not exactly the
same
field, I'm
they're
not
really
sure,
interrelated.
But it's kind of that, it's like international relations.
Yes,
what
exactly.
He does. So he really inspires me into those things. He's a great, he has a great career, actually, and he travels
and he should be very good
in
communication, too,
he's
I guess.
Perfect in communication.
Because communication doesn't come easy, you know, when you have to express your ideas and the way the other person receives them, you know, you cannot control that.
Exactly.
But while communicating, you try to give your best to whatever you're trying to convey to the other person, because it's two worlds. And what about music? What led you to music? Because I know they're all related, as you mentioned earlier, but what brought you to music?
Well, I would say I did not go to music. Music came to me. Found you, exactly. It was something that was always there. Like, I wouldn't even say there's a specific time of my life where I started thinking I should start music. Okay. It's like I was meant to do music.
Okay.
So when I was young, my dad, my mom, they used to play instruments. My mom used to play piano.
Oh, wow.
My dad used to play saxophone.
Wow.
And then it always inspired me. They were both like, they had
so
a
they
kind of,
artists
yes, they had an orchestra.
Oh, wow.
Like, I would say not a professional orchestra, but it was their thing. Mm-hmm. So at home, they used to do, like, play some nice music. Like, I always hear those sounds. I always remember them.
Okay.
So actually, I grew up in music.
Okay.
So at one point, my mom asked me what I want to do. Mm-hmm. What I want to learn as an instrument.
Yeah.
And I was like, I want to learn piano like you. Like, it's an open instrument. You can do anything with it.
Yeah, you can do anything.
So I started with piano.
Okay.
And as I had to sing a little notes like do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si.
Yeah, of course.
I would just.
So you know how to write the old music thing?
Well, yes, I actually kind of.
Well, you know
stopped,
how to read.
But
okay.
I'm not that great.
Okay.
But yeah, I learned a little bit. But what I did is I got lazy learning piano and I was more into singing.
Okay.
But right now I'm trying to start again and
of course
read
and keep
play
the skills.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm singing mostly.
Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, quiero desnudarte a veces despacito. Firmo las paredes de tu laberinto y hacer de tu cuerpo todo el manuscrito.
Why the transition? You can explain it, because it's just that there is some at some point in your life some things that attract you more than others, because I know of course the instrument are still here and as you were saying you're able to get back there and still get better at it, but I kind of understood there were a transition to the voice.
Yes. So it's all about what I kind of wanted more. I know it's not right because I should have focused learning piano, focusing and while training my voice and doing what I like in music, I
should
have.
Yeah, it does help.
But thing is, I was just more interested in piano, and my teacher used to just listen to my my caprice. I don't know if it's an actual word in English, but he would just come and I would be he would be like, "What do you want to do today? Because I don't know what to teach you."
Okay.
And I was just like, "Okay, well, play something and I'm gonna sing." So that's what happened, and I kept just singing and singing, and at one point I kind of lost a hand, like I wouldn't play anymore.
Okay.
So it's just when he wasn't there, nobody was there, and I needed an instrument.
Okay.
That's where I actually practiced a little bit, because I wanted to
and sing at the same time.
Yes,
so
I wanted
at the
to
end
sing,
of the
so
day,
I had to play.
Exactly. So at the end of the day, that's what you wanted to do.
It was just like, all about singing.
Yeah, so it came naturally, and that's what I say too, that like all the lyrics that you have in any music, it conveys a broader message.
Exactly.
And it shows a part of your personality. It shows who you are, who you truly are. Because when you go to the step to write a music and sing it, you know, out loud, that it can reach anyone, basically.
Exactly.
And for that, the message that you're trying to convey should be something true to you. Because you feel that. You feel that in different music when someone sings. When it's natural, you feel it right away. You
right
know it's
away,
not
even
something
if it's
that
not the language you speak.
Exactly.
You can actually just feel the emotion.
Yeah, exactly.
Even if it doesn't really transmit the emotion the person is trying to transmit, it's going to get to you in some kind of way.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's another story that's related to you, you're going to feel it anyway.
Of course.
As long as the person feels it.
Of course. And if you'd have to say one event or something, let's say basically that happened in your life and had a big impact on it, what would it be?
Okay, so there was this one day that I was auditioning for a contest, because I like doing that, I like challenges. So I went to Montreal the same day, came back the same day.
Okay.
And I feel like somehow I felt like I messed up the audition. Yeah, I actually did. Like,
why would you say that? Why would you say
that? Well, because it was a big audition.
Okay.
And
so you kind of lost it.
I lost it. The first, as like the the first word that came out of my mouth came out wrong. So okay. I was like, this is not going to be good. I felt bad and I knew they wouldn't call me back. I knew I didn't have it. Just.
But did you ask to restart or something like that?
Oh, no, that's not possible. Okay. They just give you one chance. You can't.
So once you start singing or doing anything.
And it's not only about the singing, it's about the talking, the charisma, everything.
Okay, of course.
And that day I just felt like everything went wrong. So I was feeling like I was the worst. Nothing is good in my life. Why did I prepare for this like 2 months and it came out so wrong? Like I'm the worst and like just everything wrong.
Everything
that day was bad. So what happened, the bus I was taking from the place I let's say the ride share so I took a bus. And then there was this guy. He was trying to communicate to find a way, but he wrote it in a paper to ask me what he wanted. And I didn't understand why. The guy was deaf and he couldn't speak either. But he had this big smile. He was so happy. It was even something contagious. You just feel his joy and you get it. And that day, I just felt like I'm the worst ever because only an audition, I'm fine. I eat when I'm hungry. I have friends. I have family.
And you're in good health.
Everything is fine for me. So that day, I started thinking I should never complain for anything. No matter what happens right now, my first goal is to learn.
Yeah, of course.
Even when I go to contests and anything, even if I don't if I don't make it to quarterfinal or anything, I just know that I have something to learn and I have to move on.
Of course.
People have much worse to
do,
and I'm young and
life.
I still have things to learn. So that would be an event that actually marked me, and I always think about it in everything I do.
Of course.
When I want to complain, I just think about that.
And this is a very strong lesson.
Yes, I know other things happen to other people, and they don't even have anybody to be there for them.
Of course.
So I'm just thanking God.
Of course. And this is a real strong lesson, and it's part of this whole idea of the podcast, which is, as I say, first to live, to learn, and to love. Because I think first to learn, because after trying to live, because I feel that there is a need to explain to people what to live is, and to live is to live mindfully, not to just be a skeleton that is passing through life without having any purpose or any idea of why you're here, what you want to do with your life. And you see nowadays a lot of people, they kind of lost in someone else's perspective. But what you just said about how it changed your whole perspective of life, of that you should think yourself as much more thankful than what you had the idea of what being thankful is.
Exactly.
Because not only with that single and simple act of smile that the person, and as you mentioned, that it's that contagious, that you feel the person, you feel their joy, and you looking at your own life with that perspective and having that broad idea and getting to learn from it is, I think, why we're all here, basically.
Exactly.
To be able to learn every day, to be able to improve every day, because we're human beings. We're not animals or something like that. We have ideas, we have minds, we can work on that and get maybe better every day. And that actually led us to, if you have social issues, any social issues, as you mentioned, that the person was mute and deaf, and he was trying to communicate with
he
you.
He took all the effort. He wrote down things. He had his notebook communicate with people. He could have given up and said, why did God do this to
exactly.
me? And I don't have to make any effort. Let me just keep up to myself and not communicate with anybody.
Of course.
He would discuss. He would write down everything.
Exactly.
He wasn't lazy at all.
He had his...
Wow. He had faith.
He had faith.
I could see that.
Definitely. Yeah. And how do you describe your spirituality or religion, or are you a religious person?
Well, I am a Muslim. I'm Senegalese, so most of us we are Muslims.
Okay.
And
how big part of the population of Senegal is Muslim?
I would say like 90% over it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, is Muslim. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's it. Yeah. We're Muslim. So mm-hmm. I am Muslim. My family, mm-hmm. most of it, we're mm-hmm. all Muslims. Mm-hmm. And well, I don't know if I really want to get into that.
Yeah,
but
course.
I can tell you for sure that I'm a Muslim.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. Because I read somewhere about Anthony Bourdain mm-hmm. when he actually went to Senegal, and he was talking about how the Muslims and the Christians and all the different religions in Senegal
mm-hmm.
live together without having the whole problem that we see in the media
mm-hmm.
and all
that's
of that.
True.
And that's why most of the time when I talk to someone else that is Senegalese, just to ask them their perspective of that exchange, mm-hmm. of that togetherness that they see in Senegal,
yes.
that I want to much more go there, because I know it's something that would interest a lot of people, hearing it from someone who's from there. Because Anthony Bourdain was not from there, but he felt it too.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people talk about that, and it's something that is of news right now,
mm-hmm.
because a lot of people tend to find separation either with your race or your color, where you're from, like your background, or your religion. And I mm-hmm. feel that doesn't define a person. What
yes.
defines a person is the act, how they act, like
yes.
their personality. I most of the time ask people from Senegal about the, mm-hmm.
that
the interrelationship.
Yes, mm-hmm. I definitely believe in it.
Mm-hmm.
And we have neighbors that are Christians, mm-hmm. but
exactly.
we're so good. Like, it's just complementary.
Mm-hmm.
When they're celebrating mm-hmm. any Christian
mm-hmm.
Event, Christmas.
Even Christmas that is coming.
Yes,
yeah.
it's mm-hmm. just, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
And Muslims too,
mm-hmm.
when we have Eid
mm-hmm.
and everything, when we're done with the,
mm-hmm.
We just give
yeah.
them, we serve them food, everything.
Exactly.
And they
and
are
Bengala.
Yeah, Bengala, exactly.
People can
I don't know
that.
The word in English, but I was going to talk about it.
They were probably going to Google it.
Yes, well. I don't know if it's in Google anyway.
They will see.
But yeah, we always share. We believe in sharing,
mm-hmm.
and it's beautiful. Not only the religion.
exactly.
Senegalese people, like, you can't live in Senegal and starve.
Of course.
That's the thing.
Of course.
If you don't have anything, at least you have food, because
mm-hmm.
everybody shares.
Yeah.
And you're welcome to every house.
Mm-hmm.
You can go anywhere.
Yeah,
and,
exactly.
And you'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
It's family.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, I think that was the end of our discussion. Maybe not the end of our exchange, but do you have an online presence that maybe the listeners could follow you through?
Well, yes, I'm on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
It's a GAMOU_DIOP.
Mm-hmm.
So I post some acapellas,
mm-hmm.
some anything I do in music, in my real life,
mm-hmm.
pictures, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And YouTube too, it's GAMOOZA.
Mm-hmm.
And Facebook, GAMU_DIOP. So everything is just my name, Gamu
okay.
Diop.
Okay.
Basically. So.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
It was really refreshing having all these ideas and talking about in part of Senegal and all these subjects. And hopefully we will have another session at any
of
point
course.
In
it
life, inshallah,
nice.
As we used to say. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Talk to you next time.
Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído, para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, que quiero desnudarte a besos despacito. Firme las paredes de tu laberinto, que hacer de tu cuerpo todo el manuscrito. Louis down, you don't stop, follow. I just wanna hear you screaming, ay bendito. I can live forever cuando esté contigo. Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito. Nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito.
Thank you. Please share, subscribe, and review. Also, you can follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at MV3 Universe. And until next time, never forget, you're as unique as the universe. Peace be with you.